Workflow Intro. In this course, the most panels we will use are the Appearance panel, the Graphic Styles, the Assets Export panel, and the Character panel. Let's put it here in the side so we have easy access to it. So let's first go to Windows and choose the Appearance panel here. You can either choose Appearance or hit Shift F6 as you can see. Let's open that panel. Let's drag it out. Close the Graphics panel for now and drag the Appearance panel here. The next one we'll use is the Graphic Style panel. So we'll scroll all the way down to the G, Shift F6 as you can see, Graphic Styles, drag that out and drag it back in here above the Appearance panel. There you go. The next one is the Asset Export panel. So again, go to Window, Asset Export. As you can see, there is no shortcut for that. Open it up, drag it out and drag it back in. It was already on the right spot, but just so you can see how it works. And the last one, or better, the first one we'll always use is the Character panel. So let's open up the window and have a look. As you can see, there's no Character panel. Let's see, you have to scroll all the way down to Styles. Let's click down because my scroll wheel isn't working on this menu. And as you can see here, Type, it says Character or Control T. So let's open that. As you can see, there was nothing there yet in the side panel. So let's drag it out here. Let's close this panel and let's drag the Character panel in this side panel here. As you can see, we now also have the Character panel. So we can use the shortcuts Control T for the Character panel, Shift F6 for the Appearance panel, Shift F5 for the Graphics panel, and there is none for the Asset Export panel. We can use Control Alt E. It'll open up this Export for Screens window and we can here choose Asset Export panel. Strange way to go, but just so you know that it's there. Let's close that again and let's have a look at what this course is about. If you want, you can follow along. Let's first choose the pen tool and let's draw something. Just click on a few points, maybe drag a little bit. This is an intermediate course, so I expect you to already know how this works. Let's go back to the selection tool. Let's drag this to the middle. When you go to view and look at outline here, or Control and Y as a shortcut, you only see the outline of the object without any fill color or any stroke color, any stroke thickness. You only see the anchor points and the path and a sort of bounding box so you can scale it and stuff like that. And I'm showing this because this is the base of the object. I want you to understand that every object has a base like this. Just anchors, Bezier curves and path, stuff like that. Okay, so let's go back with Control Y to the normal view and let's give this a color. For example, let's make this red instead of white. And let's give the stroke a green color and let's make the stroke a little bit thicker so you can see it a little bit better. So as you can see, when you go to Control Y now, the object is still the same. It just has a different stroke and a different fill. And the stroke and fill is sort of like the makeup of this object. So it's not really changing the object itself. It's just giving it a different makeup or a different costume if you like. And that's kind of the basic of this course. We don't change objects itself. We only change the looks of it. That almost brings us to the end of this lecture, but let's first look at this character panel here. I click on the little hamburger here, and as you can see, there's a show options. I open it up. It'll expand the panel with some extra character options. I have attached an info sheet, so if you want to know more about the characteristics of characters, then you can have a look there. So let's close the character panel again, and let's go to the next lecture. Okay, bye-bye.